A video showing a converted Chinese factory producing N95 masks for medical staff is raising concern. Chinese authorities take issue with a woman's gift of Bibles and masks to her family in China. Chinese-listed company on the New York Stock Exchange, GSX Techedu, is facing allegations of fraud. And a new Western intelligence dossier states the Chinese regime intentionally hid evidence leading to the pandemic. Find out what's included in the 15-page document.
Welcome to China in Focus. I'm Tiffany Meyer. Many Chinese factories have little or no business during the outbreak, so they've started producing face masks instead. But countries around the world have reported serious quality issues with China's masks. A video circulating on social media sheds some light on why that may be. This is where the N95 face masks for medical staff are packed. Two of the workers aren't wearing gloves, and they're all just wearing regular clothes, no protective suits. At least two of the workers aren't wearing masks. They've packed quite a lot. Again, a man packing masks without gloves, a mask, or a protective suit. These are regular face masks. It's unclear if the environment has been sanitized. Someone sweeping the floor while people are working nearby. It appears to be a big factory. This is an auto factory in the U.S. It's also started producing face masks during the pandemic. May 1st is the first day of a five-day holiday in China. People usually travel during this time, but this year there are still restrictions in place. An official announcement says only 3 out of 5 sightseeing spots in Hubei province have reopened. And one of Wuhan's most famous hotspots is still closed. For those that have reopened, they will only allow 30% of the usual number of tourists in, and they must wear face masks, show their green health code, keep social distancing, and not gather together. Now to China's northernmost province, Heilongjiang. According to state-run media, local authorities in Harbin City have issued an urgent notice. Certain restaurants, like barbecues, will be closed from May 2nd. A date for reopening has not been announced. According to internal documents obtained by NTD, the outbreak in Harbin is out of control. The leading group for combating the epidemic in Heilongjiang sent a warning letter to its Harbin branch on April 13th. The letter says there's been a coronavirus outbreak in Harbin and cases of community spread are increasing. Now to Beijing. According to local media, in the first 4 months of the year, Beijing's park saw less than half the number of visitors at the same time last year. Visitors must wear face masks and have their temperature taken before entering the parks. Beijing citizens have been told to prioritize prevention and control of the virus, wash their hands frequently, disinfect environments frequently, practice social distancing, air rooms out frequently, and not gather in large groups. Another Chinese-listed company on the New York Stock Exchange is being accused of fraud. GSX Techedu, an online education company, has come under fire for fabricating its number of registered users. Citron Research released a statement on April 30th stating there was conclusive evidence GSX Techedu overstates revenues and profits. According to the release, 40% of GSX's 2019 registered users were fake. Citron Research previously published a report on April 14th saying the company's 2019 revenue was overstated by 70%. Citron Research said on May 1st the feedback from China on GSX has been amazing, adding there are many honest Chinese people who want to see this gone, and calling it the next Luckin Coffee, which also came under fire for fraud charges earlier this year. In an interview with CNBC, the president of the EU showed support for a proposed investigation into the origin of the CCP virus. Ursula von der Leyen said on May 1st, "We've learned lessons this time," adding governments need to establish an early warning system with robust data. And to do that, they need transparency.
And the whole world has to contribute to that.
Some German, Swedish, and Australian parliamentarians are calling for an investigation into the origin of the CCP virus.
This is for all of us important. I mean, for the whole world it is important.
A research dossier by the Five Eyes Intelligence Agency, comprised of the US, Canada, the UK, Australia, and New Zealand, states the Chinese regime intentionally hid or destroyed evidence of the virus outbreak, leading to tens of thousands of deaths around the world. The 15-page document obtained by Australian Daily Telegraph covers the Chinese regime's mistakes, including denial of human-to-human transmission, destroying virus lab samples, disinfecting the Huanan seafood market before investigations could occur, and refusing to provide samples to international scientists for vaccine development. The dossier also provides a timeline for China's response to the virus outbreak, including the silencing of whistleblower Dr. Li Wenliang. The regime also began censoring search term words that day, deleting terms like SARS variation, Wuhan seafood market, and Wuhan unknown pneumonia. The report goes on to state that in February, China pressured the U.S., Italy, India, Australia, and Southeast Asian neighbors not to protect themselves via travel restrictions. This despite China itself implementing severe travel restrictions. The Saturday Telegraph reported on Australia's involvement, highlighting two key figures at the Wuhan Institute of Virology, Dr. Shi Zhenli and Zhou Peng, who worked in Australia for 5 years, focusing their research on incurable bat coronaviruses. A German media is calling for antibodies not just against the virus, but also against the Chinese communist regime. An opinion piece in the Welt says China is waging a propaganda of lies and calls out the German government and the EU for not speaking out against the regime. The op-ed calls for effective antibodies against the economic and political influence of dictatorships. Giving masks has become a way for some Chinese people to show their love to their families. One woman, however, became a target of the CCP because she sent masks and Bibles from America to China.
Xiu Nuo says she mailed some masks and several Bibles to her family when the epidemic broke out in China. She was shocked to hear her father was harassed by the CCP when the Bibles were discovered in the mail.
My father was taken to the police station to be interrogated. The police officers think I must belong to an anti-Chinese religious movement overseas, or that I might want to bring my family here to fight against China. In short, the police took my father away from home to interrogate him, then quarantined him in very poor conditions, and he had to pay the costs of being quarantined. My father is very old. He was hurt greatly, both physically and mentally.
Xiu donated 6,000 medical masks to a hospital in Los Angeles. She expressed hope that Americans will understand that the Chinese people are also victims of the pandemic and that the CCP caused the outbreak to spread.
I believe many innocent people in the world would not have died if the communist regime and the communist party had immediately announced to the world the true information about the virus when it just happened. That is to say, the Chinese regime and the CCP did a very bad thing and cost many people lives. I am very angry about that.
Xiu says during the pandemic, she came to understand the true nature of the CCP. She says the regime has slaughtered people and persecuted faith groups and hopes people will learn from her experience and stay away from the communist regime.
Can China be held responsible for the global pandemic? To sue the regime in an international court is nearly impossible, but there might be a way forward. Our correspondent David Vives spoke to a civil liberties lawyer.
The CCP virus has killed over 240,000 people across the globe and paralyzed economies. Beijing has been slapped with around 10 lawsuits, from Missouri and Mississippi to private companies in Europe to UK leader Boris Johnson. According to experts, China has violated Articles 6 and 7 of the International Health Regulations. The IHR is a treaty that China signed and is legally obliged to uphold. In France, members of parliament want to bring the regime to justice. Guillaume Peltier, vice president of a conservative parliament group, is one of them.
Guillaume Peltier said that China and WHO should be held responsible for the crisis. He calls for the creation of an international health court on the model of the International Criminal Court created in The Hague in 1998.
But is it possible to bring China to international court? According to French lawyer Pierre Farge, no state can take legal action against another state or nation. It's an issue of sovereignty. In other words, the U.S. can't force China to accept any lawsuit.
Here's an example. After 9/11, some states in the USA filed a suit against Saudi Arabia, and it's still going on. On first instance, this suit has been rejected because of the sovereignty issue.
The U.S. wants the UN Security Council to pass a resolution identifying China as a source of the virus. It's a claim Beijing has denied. According to Farge, neither the UN Council nor the International Criminal Court can do anything. But there's one solution that could work.
That's if European countries and maybe the US come together and hold China responsible and decide to impose an independent investigation on Chinese soil. We saw Australia try to impose this investigation, but failed. One country can't really do something, but if many countries come together, China won't have the power to refuse in the end.
Report by David Vives, NTD News.
California, one of the few states keeping a tight hold on restrictions, sparking protests. The governor says more freedom could be days away. But some counties are already open. One even reopened businesses yesterday.
California is among a small handful of states tightening restrictions as the majority of the nation takes steps towards reopening.
Open California! Open California!
And restless residents are not thrilled. A protest sparking in San Francisco Friday.
Americans under the Constitution have a right to assemble, they have a right to pursue happiness, and this draconian effort is definitely government overreach. We're standing on principle.
The protest took place the same day orders to close some beaches went into effect. City council officials voted to try to block the governor's order, but the request was turned down by California's Superior Court.
Because the damage from what's going on now in this country, in this state, is worse than a virus.
While the beaches will stay closed for now, Newsom says more freedom and looser restrictions are right around the corner.
We're getting very close to making really meaningful augmentations to that stay-at-home order. We are, you know, I always said weeks, not months, about 4 or 5 days ago. I want to say many days, not weeks.
But some California counties aren't willing to wait on Newsom to give them the green light. One county letting nearly all businesses reopen yesterday, even bars and restaurants. Other counties preparing guidelines for businesses to open soon. State Senator Jim Nielsen, representing the counties, saying the situation is dire, in a statement saying some workers only have $20 to their name. Melina Weisskopf, NTD News.
More states announced their plans for recovery, but Massachusetts is not one of them. The state's now seeing the highest number of daily cases in the nation, and the University of Texas is being probed about its dealings with the Chinese regime.
New Hampshire, Indiana, and Oregon. Three more states are now tacked onto the list of 38 that are loosening restrictions on businesses. Now, 41 states are on the path to economic recovery. That includes universities, which in some southern states are letting students come back this fall. While some colleges are working on reopening plans, the University of Texas has more weighty responsibilities on its to-do list. The U.S. Department of Education is asking the school for more transparency about their relations with China. In their letter to the university, the department says the school has received nearly $13 million worth of contracts with Chinese state universities and Huawei Technologies. But the letter says it's not clear if the university has reported all dealings with China. And in New York, 200 to 300 people are still dying each day from the CCP virus. But that's down from the roughly 700 daily deaths the city saw until recently. Fewer people are being admitted to hospitals, and fewer new cases are appearing each day, significantly less than weeks ago.
Was also down a little bit, 831. It had been relatively flat at about 900 every day.
That's not the case in Massachusetts, which now has the highest number of daily new cases, around 2,000 every day. All residents are to wear masks in public now under the governor's new order. Massachusetts and New York are the hardest hit in the nation. They're among 12 states expecting a slower economic recovery. Ohio is on that list too, being the latest to extend the stay-at-home order to the end of May. Melina Weisskopf, NTD News.
The price of gold fell in recent days, but has been rallying since the beginning of the pandemic. Investors see gold as a safe haven during times of uncertainty.
Since the beginning of the year, the price of gold is up over 10%. Compare that to major indexes like the NASDAQ, which is down 4%, or Dow Jones down 16%. Gold has historically been a safe haven for investors during times of uncertainty.
For thousands of years, gold has acted as a hedge against uncertainty. It's acted as a currency, and it's acted as a store of wealth.
As lockdowns bring business to a standstill, countries like the U.S. have been forced to print money to stimulate the economy. This has helped to prop up stock markets, but the increased supply will devalue the currency itself.
They are printing more paper money in every country via every Treasury Department, via every central bank. Gold, relative to those paper currencies, becomes more and more valuable.
As lockdowns are lifted and the virus is brought under control, you may see investors move towards higher risk bets again. But change always brings opportunity. The recent oil price crash has made gold exploration companies an even more attractive investment.
As oil drops and gold stays at the same price or moves higher, the ramifications for producers are significant because one of their large input costs has moved lower.
Will the gold run continue? We'll wait and see.
In New York, living under lockdown has left people with plenty of time to try new things, like caring for a dog. Hopeful owners are sending adoption applications to animal shelters by the thousands.
As lockdowns remain in effect due to the presence of the coronavirus, animal shelters in the New York City area are facing a potential shortage of furry companions to adopt. Now, nonprofits are doing their best to meet the demand, which has increased by 17 times.
A little over a month, ever since the shelter in place and quarantine period began, we've received over 4,000 foster applications.
Foster Dogs, Inc. is not an isolated case. Muddy Paws Rescue, another nonprofit organization, is also seeing this new trend.
Our foster applications, generally, we get about 100 a month. In March, we got 1,133, so it was a big month.
All in all, it seems like the increased demand is a pleasant problem for volunteers like Sarah.
While people are sheltering in place, while they're quarantined indoors, animals are really winning. Foster dogs, shelter dogs are really winning in this entire coronavirus experience.
However, there is concern over what will happen to these animals after lockdown ends. Some say that they could be admitted back to shelters as people go back to work and are no longer able to care for them.
In contrast to other European countries which are lifting measures, France is extending its lockdown and imposing new restrictions.
Even though most European countries are lifting their measures, France is extending its state of emergency. Not only are they extending the current measures, but also imposing a new one. Travelers to France, including French citizens returning home, will now face compulsory quarantine. In Germany, a cruise ship with nearly 3,000 crew members on board is in quarantine after one of the members tested positive. The entire crew had already been in isolation on board for over 4 weeks, and some were transferred onto the ship from other cruise liners. Indian police found 18 migrant workers hidden in the barrel of a cement mixer truck. India's strict lockdown is challenging for migrant workers who aren't allowed to travel home but also don't have enough money to stay in the states where they work. But in the northern part of India, a famous floating vegetable market remains open. After collecting vegetables from wholesalers, vendors deliver them to homes along the lake. Even though social distancing is a challenge, it's still considered safer than going to grocery stores.
And in order to avoid human-to-human transmission of the virus, some countries are counting on the help of robots.
Argentina is looking for new ways to disinfect public transportation and other frequently visited places. A small robot might make all the difference. A company in the South American country is testing a machine that can sanitize spaces and objects with ultraviolet light. The light emitted from the device destroys the DNA of bacteria and the RNA of viruses. According to the WHO, traditional cleaning methods are only 60% effective, whereas the new device is said to be more than 99% effective. Another advantage of using cleaning robots is that no one has to enter the contaminated room. And Japan is using robots as well. A hotel in Tokyo opened for patients with lighter symptoms who do not need hospital treatment. The hotel is using two types of robots. One robot is programmed with positive messages to help patients stay positive. The other is an AI robot that cleans. An app will also allow patients to record their temperature with a smartphone.
Here at China in Focus, we dedicate ourselves to bringing you truthful, unbiased reporting. Don't forget to subscribe for the latest updates and see you next time.